Good morning. Back benches conference. I cannot shout a lot, please. I am not going to need to come. Come front. In your front lavanga. You are hiding back behind the pillar, I won't be able to see you here. So yeah, good morning again. How many of you seeing me for the first time? First time? How many? Many? Good. Okay. I'm Abhishek. Okay. I'm from Chennai. I have given 3 attempts in UPSC, this including the latest one, 2019 attempt. Last year I got 369 rank. Okay, I'm an optionless history. Okay, so what is the purpose actually of meeting today? What is the purpose? Okay, just want to know the thing, like how many of you are giving for the first time prelims or appearing for the UPSC for the first time? No idea, nothing. Everyone repeater? Okay, good. So basics, we'll come to basics now. Which paper? Breakfast done, or shall I order something for you? Juice, tea, coffee? I'll do it. So which paper? Yes, one. Okay. Have you, so what do you think, like seen the paper of this year? This year's mains paper. How many of you haven't seen? Haven't seen? Did not see? Why? Don't want to write mains? Huh? Yes. How many haven't seen the paper? Did not see the paper? This year's mains paper. Everyone, you didn't see. Good. At least honest guy. Okay. So, not this year, but at least last 3 years paper. Have you seen? Okay. Particularly related to only world history. Our topic will be just concise to world history. Okay. So, if you have seen last 3 years paper, because I have given mains for last 3 years, so 17, 18, 19. Okay. So, from my analysis, okay, 6, 17, 18, and this year's mains. At least 20, 25 marks. So this is the weightage of world history. Okay, this is the weightage of world history in respect to mains. Okay, prelims till now in last 20, 30 years, you haven't got any single question from world history. Though it will help you to solve other answers. Okay, maybe geography answers, answer society maybe. Okay, but not directly any question from world history in prelims. Okay, so. 15-10. So you can make an average of around 15 marks you'll get in mains every year for from world history. That means maybe one question. Okay, so why to study then? Leave it one question, right? One question, leave it. Leave it, right? We cannot. Each mark does when the competition is cutthroat basically. Except top 50 ranks, you have at least 10 candidates in every single total. Okay, so you cannot ignore even a single mark. Okay, and also many people tend to ignore this topic. Why? Very vast, boring, right? That's why, and not interested. Okay, just 15 marks, why to go through this, why to struggle? Okay, they may tend to pick up this topic maybe the 10 days before mains. Okay, but they fail badly. Okay, so don't ignore it. That's the first advice. Then, how to approach to this? What can be your approach? So first thing, not only for world history, for all the topics of all the papers, GS, prelims, mains, interview, your syllabus. Syllabus, okay. First thing, you need to stick to the syllabus, particularly world history topic. Why? Sticking to syllabus for history topics, because it's a static subject. What happened in the history, it remained the same, right? It doesn't change. Okay, so stick to the topic, stick to the syllabus basically. So what is the syllabus? Tell me, from where did the world history we start to tell me? Hmm? 1750, what? Yes, industrial revolution. Then Renaissance is for optional. Who told Renaissance? Optional history. Then it's for optional, not for GSP. Come timeline wise. See, the best way to answer any question history, if you don't have any data, any fact you are getting, okay, just take the timeline. Answer what happened 10 years before this, what happened 10 years after this. Example, if the question is on industrial revolution, okay, 1750s industrial revolution, 1700 what happened, after 1750s what happened. So that will be the causes for industrial revolution, after that impact of industrial revolution. Okay, that is one structure you can adopt for answering any question on history. You can write it down. Okay, for answering any question in history, maybe your ancient, medieval, modern world, timeline approach. 10 years to 20 years or maybe 50 years before and 50 years after. Causes, impact. Finished? Then, and that will also make your answer structured. You can prioritize your point. Okay. Yeah. I'll give an example of this question also. This year we had one question, if you remember your mains paper, we had a question of Gandhi. Okay, Gandhian era. Okay. Gandhian era influenced, the Gandhian phase gave new energy to many voices. Such, that was a question, okay. That means the answer was huge. I need to write entire Gandhian era. When Gandhi came to India in 1917-16 till 1947. Okay. That's a big answer, but only 3 pages to go. You can write anything, everything will be correct. But that may not fetch you good marks. How to approach? Start from the time when Gandhi came. 1916-17, Champaran Satyagraha, go timeline wise. NCM, non-cooperation movement, civil disobedience movement, yes. Then Congress form, party formation, this Swarajist, all these things, right. Then go back again, 1929, Simon Commission, okay. This will be a structure. So you complete your answer holistically and you also present your point in a priority order. That's an example of using timeline. Okay, in history, use timeline. Wherever possible, when you are not getting what to write, how to write, use timeline approach. Fine. Yeah, coming back. So industrial revolution, then next. American War of Independence, then. Then yeah, in general we say nation state. You told socialism, capitalism, all this theory, they also emerge because of impact of industrial revolution, American revolution, French revolution. All these ideologies, right? Then again, because of industrial revolution, okay, more production, all this thing, you also had the era of yes. Then unification. Germany and yes, then First World War is in 1914. So miscellaneous topics. That is international era. Okay. There's one more famous term called as great game, basically capturing colonies. Finally, World War I. What are the causes of World War? These are the causes of World War from the Industrial Revolution till the Great Game. If each point is correct, okay, you get 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 points. Write with an example, game over. 15 mark answer completed. You can just remember the syllabus, you can complete your answers in world history. That's what I want to say. That's why syllabus is important. Reading will not help you that much, because 15 minutes, 15 marks, 11 minutes, 10 mark question, 7 minutes. You can only shit there. Oh shit, or you shit there. Okay, but shit it in a proper way. That's what we say. Okay. Mains is not about completing paper. Okay. It's not about writing fast, it's about thinking fast. Okay. So make structure. Okay. Even while reading, not even writing, but also when you are reading or remembering. Okay. After World War One, then 1917, Russian Revolution, yes. 1918, your World War One ended, right? Then till 1939, whatever happened, this becomes the causes of World War Two. Okay, I think you all have read at least once, so I will not elaborate, just writing the keywords: appeasement policy, Treaty of Versailles, Nazis and fascist ideologies, all these things. Yes? Right? There are many more instances which happened between 1918 to 1939. 20 years of 20 decade, 2 decades of all this incident led to your World War II. World War II got over in 1945. What after 1945? Cold War. This ended in 1991 until what is going on till today. Okay. Post India consolidation, world history is not that static. Okay, they can ask you a question with even with related to current affair events. They can ask you a question like 2018 we had a question on Indian diaspora. It was an indirect world history question, but why? It is linked to current affair, because government was focusing more on Pravasi Bharatiya Divas, getting the support of Indian diaspora, bringing them to limelight. Okay, that was the indirect question. You can get a question on Cold War 2.0, not imperialism but neo-imperialism. Okay, something like that. Basis will be your world history and map with current affair. Okay, so your newspaper reading will also help you. Okay, so this is the basic timeline of your syllabus. Yes, basic timeline of the syllabus. Then how to approach, what books to read, tell me. What to read who haven't started world history at all, haven't touched world history at all? Anyone? Everyone have touched at least once. Sure. Sure. What are the books? Tell me. Are you, tell the books. You studied, right? From where you studied? Went to NCERT. Arjun Dev, right? That is the standard book. Okay, that's the first thing. Study that once, twice, thrice. Okay, not much, but at least get the story. Get the story. Need not mug up the book. Get the story, just like a novel. Okay, just like a you remember the story of a movie. Okay, or a novel. Remember the story. Yes. Then is that enough? Is that enough? 2017-16, there was a question on decolonization process of West Africa. 2015 East Africa. 2016 again they asked a question. Sykes-Picot Agreement, what is this? The Sykes-Picot Agreement of 1930s is still hovering the Asian crisis. That was the question, what will write? That was the question. It came from Norman Lo. Heard about this book? Norman Lo. Okay. I am not asking you to study that book. Okay, not asking you to study that book. First you stick to the standard source. Okay? Standard source, Arjun Dev. You can use YouTube. Okay, if you are not understanding any topic, you are getting bored that you cannot don't want to read more books, okay, you can use YouTube. Okay, follow this channel. Okay, the channel name is Crash Course. Type Crash Course World History. Okay, it's by an American historian. Excellent videos. Almost all the topics of the syllabus is available there. Okay, you can refer it, just 9 to 10 minutes video each. Okay, you can get an idea. Once you complete your book, you can listen to it whenever you are feeling bored, you don't want to take the book back for revision, you can use this channel. Even in optional, you follow this channel. Okay, so that is one extra thing I want to tell you. Okay, those are like already studied books. Please use this channel to just add on to your preparation. Okay, to help you in any ways. Yeah. Then, yeah, I was talking about Norman Lo. Okay, Norman Lo, use that as a supplementary book. Supplementary book. Okay, there are some topics which are not covered anywhere in your Arjun or any other standard material. The same example of decolonization of East Africa, decolonization of West Africa. Okay, this will be not present in Arjun Dev, but in syllabus, if you see, you have a word called decolonization. Decolonization is the broad word UPSC has given. They can ask you from anywhere, everywhere. Okay, so you can refer that book for such particular topics. Need not study the wars of world. What were the wars fought in the World War? All this thing need not study. Okay, only use it for some topics which are not there in any book. Okay, that's it. Okay, like West Asia. Israel-Palestine conflict, history of Israel-Palestine conflict. It's not there, I think, in Arjun Dev also. Use Norman Lo for that. It's a very simple language. It's a very simple language. Okay, need not mug up facts, need not mug up dates. In history, don't think that it's mug upping facts, mug upping all this name. Need not. Just concept. Whatever you do in your other subjects, the same thing in history. Okay, just one or two facts to substantiate your point. Okay, need not remember date, exact date like this. You need not remember. Just like 1770, 1780s. More than enough. Okay, so remove this myth that you have to remember dates, you have to remember your facts. Not at all required, not at all required. Okay, then, so yeah, we'll discuss some question. Okay, if you, the first thing, like before you go to your preparation, okay, thing is you just analyze at least last 5 years paper. Okay, and see how the question trend are. Okay, the questions are not direct, straightforward. Okay, the questions are more of analytical nature. They are not asking what is industrial revolution, they are asking why industrial revolution, or what is the irrelevant of industrial revolution in the current era, maybe something like that. Okay, not what is Cold War, why Cold War, is Cold War still prevailing, that can be your question. So it's more analytical. For that you need to understand the concept of Cold War. Okay, whatever you study in world history, that is about Cold War, but you need to move one step ahead. Why Cold War happened? What was the reason for Cold War? Is it still going on? If yes, yes, give example. That is the way you need to study history. Okay, don't just stick on to your standard books and yes, I'll write that content, my work is over. No, when you study newspaper, bring that content over. If you're reading the tension between US and China, trade wars, all these things, it's nothing but Cold War 2.0. Only players have changed. From Russia, it became China. think in that way. Yes, think in that way. Okay, so this is the way you should link your current affair knowledge with history, and not only history, also all your subjects. That is the preparation for mains basically. That is your mains preparation, and that is you, if you implement that, becomes your answer writing practice. Okay. So I'll give you some question like previous year's UPSC question. Same like very simple question. To what extent can Germany be held responsible for causing two world wars? The directive is discuss critically. Discuss critically. This discuss critically, discuss, analyze, examine. These are very important in UPSC. If you don't follow it, you won't get marks. Okay. Anyone can fill 3 pages for two, preparing for 2 years, 3 years. We have that knowledge that we can fill 3 pages easily. Okay. Thing is, we need to follow the directive. UPSC is testing UI. Good bureaucrat is one who obeys government orders but doesn't question. He should not question, he should not use his brain too much. Okay, they are training it from the mains exam itself. Okay, do whatever we say, don't do extra. You won't get marks. Exactly, right? Because you have knowledge, you can do, you can write anything, not an issue. But thing is, you follow our orders. Okay, that's where the basic training starts from the mains itself. Okay, so yeah, coming back to question, to what extent can Germany be held responsible for causing world war, two world wars? So what can we, like, yeah, again coming back to answer writing, it's all about answer writing at last, right? Whatever you read, how much you read, it's about answer writing. So just write out this, write down this question, the same question. To what extent, to what extent and remember, you need to write this answer in 11 minutes. 15 mark question, 11 minutes, okay? Maybe. Okay. So, to what extent can Germany be held responsible? Can Germany be held responsible for two world wars? For the two world wars. Okay. Sir, you are not writing? Okay. So, to what extent Germany be held responsible, can Germany be held responsible two world wars? Discuss critically. So I want you to make the structure of this answer. Need not worry about the content, you may not remember now, but structure, what will be the structure for the answer? That is important. Please do it. Make the structure for the answer. Okay, make a body framework. In that you can put in your content when you read. Done. Done. Just structure, only structure. What can be your intro? what can be the introduction in this question. For any question, start with an introduction. Whether you have time, you don't have time, give at least one line or two line introduction, first thing. So now think, what can be your introduction? Definitely, I'm sure everyone will start with introduction. Tell me what can be your introduction. See, introduction can fetch you half of the mark. The first thing the examiner will read is introduction. When I correct papers, the only thing I read is introduction. That shows me, yes, he understood the question, and the other part of the answer will be according to the introduction. So I'll tend to give him more marks, and I won't even read the content of the body that much, interestingly, okay? Thing is, he understood the question well, that's it. That's my aim. So what can be the introduction for this question? Think, read the question again. Two world wars. Pauses is only Second World War. Powers? Okay. Then? So, no, frame it. I'm telling you, I give you time, 1 minute time. Make an introduction now. The keyword are two world wars and Germany. And discuss critically. Two world wars, Germany responsible, and discuss critically. I think all whatever answer I got now, yes, they are on the same line. Now make it into a sentence, two or three line sentence. Try. The hint for the introduction, the hint for the making structure will be in the question itself. The question will give you all the hints. Okay, don't worry about that. I'll tell you how. Now make an intro. Remember, when you write intro, it should be informative. Examiner should know, yes, you understood the question. Anyone ready for the intro? Doesn't matter, wrong, right, doesn't matter. Tell me. Not that relevant. More of philosophical, historian type of introduction. It's okay, but still, yes. Tell me. I need answer from almost everyone. Tell. Yes. Somewhere near, but I want you to demarcate World War One, two World Wars, World War One, World War Two. Okay, any more intro? Yes, that is thing. How can we write in crisp manner? Challenges we know. Thing is, we need to write complete in. Introduction will be around 60 words, that's it. How to write in 60 words, that is the challenge. We can write the point, not enough, but 60 words, 70 words, 20 words, yes. Yes. It will be too big, and again, you are focusing only on Germany. I told you, discuss critically. That should also be shown, yes. you have understood the directive also. Any more intro? World War II, yeah, that is correct. We need to write that, that is paka correct. Okay. So, what I would have written, Caesar William II, the imperialist policy of Caesar William II. Okay. And the Nazist ideology of Hitler I was the cause of two world wars. Okay. Because that shows that Germany was responsible. But along with that, failure of League of Nations, appeasement policy of the British and French was equally responsible for the conflict among the nations in the world. So I showed Germany was responsible. I showed not only Germany was responsible. Okay, simple intro. And I know some names, Caesar William II, Hitler, you can write dates 1914, 1939, whatever you want. Okay, Nazist policy. So simple intro. I'm telling them, yes, Germany was responsible. Germany was also not, Germany alone was not responsible. That shows that yes, I understood the question. Yes, I understood the question. Okay. Then what will be the structure? That is the intro. Three lines, maybe two, three lines maximum. What is the next? What can be the next structure after introduction? Body. What will come in the body? What will come in the body? What is the structure you have formed? Introduction you have given. Then in body, what will be the thing? How you are going to proceed in body? Yes. Yes, exactly. Thing is, we need to show here demarcation in the question itself. Germany was responsible for two world wars. That's the question. First side heading can be Germany was responsible for World War I. Write the cause. Write the why Germany was responsible. Maybe 3-4 points you will get there. Second side heading, Germany was responsible for World War II. Write 3-4 points there. Okay. Then come to other heading. Not only Germany was responsible, there were other causes as well for two world wars. Write some 5-6 points over there. So you demarcated when examiner correct. You will just see the heading. Yes, one, Germany. Then third is your critical discuss part. Getting it? Getting it? It is from the question itself. Germany was responsible for two world wars. World War I, World War II. Not only, now coming to discuss critically, not only Germany was responsible. So, 1, 2, 3 parts. Getting it? Then come to the conclusion. Final conclusion. Right? That is your basic structuring. Getting it? In the question itself, you take the side headings. Use side headings to show the examiner that you answered each part of the question. Side heading is not for beautifying your answer, filling the pages. To show the examiner that you have answered all the parts of the question. It's very important. If you want to score in mains, you need to write side headings to show the examiner that yes, you have addressed all part of the question. That they won't have time. That they won't have time to look, yes, you have answered this. They will deduct your mark. They will not award you, but they will definitely reduce your marks. Okay. So make your answer as visible as possible. Okay. Yes, the side headings are there, suitable side headings are there. Content can be up and down, good or bad, doesn't matter. But you'll get marks for that structuring alone. Because you have addressed all part of the question. Come to the conclusion. There's a scope of map also. Like you can draw a map in this question. What can the map tell me? What can the map tell me? How can we, you can, that map is like any diagram or map, whatever. It should not be just a map. It should be informative. It should convey some information. What information can you show through map or diagrams in this question? That one way, simple way of showing, yes. Then you can, what I can do is I can mark the countries, maybe US, the major countries, US, Japan, Italy, okay, and just write one point about them, why they were responsible, each of them were responsible. League of Nations, US was not the part, Italy, Fascism, Germany, Nazism, there may be some repetition, but it looks nice. It looks nice. Particularly when you have 3 pages, you don't have much to fill. Okay, you can use this diagrams. Okay. So try to use diagrams in an informative way. I have seen people just drawing this. They write World War. And I do like this. I won't even give them a single mark. For option student I'm talking, even GS the same thing follows. Okay, any diagram, any subject, maybe geography, economics, history, polity, informative diagrams. Okay, diagram should convey information. You can cut down your points, maybe you can just write 2, 2, 3, 3 points in your sidedings. Use the map to convey some 10 points here in a single word, just a single word, right? Getting it, how to write? Getting it? That's the way you have to follow. Okay, it's not only for history, I'm just talking about world history, but the structuring should be done for all the papers, GS paper 1, 2, 3, because GS paper 4 you don't have any structure. Okay, it's more of about your own personality what you write. Ethics, there is no structuring at all, you can write in any way you want to, fine. So we'll practice one more time now. Yes, okay, I'll give you one more question. This time you try to put some content, if you remember, just that point, need not write the entire sentence, just a point, a fact, whatever you remember. Was American War of Independence, was American War of Independence a true revolution? A true revolution or a mere civil war? Okay, remove that word, mere civil war, just simple question. Was American War of Independence, was a true revolution? Discuss. For this question, I'll give you 10 minutes, okay, 12.5 mark question, maybe 2 pages, try to write, generate some 12 to 15 points in this question. If you're not any content, just try to write 2, 3 points, but make a structure. one more minute or done. Last 2 minutes, okay? Try complete. And try to generate good conclusion. Try to write complete conclusion. What can be a conclusion? Good conclusion. That will leave the last impression, okay? Introduction and conclusion should be good. Okay, content can be normal, just relevant content will do. Try to give good conclusion. I'll tell you what can you add in conclusion and how can you generate conclusion. Okay? For world history and history questions. Shall we start? Okay. Intro. Introduction. Introduction. Say, what are we doing for the last 10 minutes then? Okay, you are defining or fine. Yeah, okay, that's one. So certain treaties means write one or two treaties. Yes. Okay, then that's fine enough then. That is very far fetched. That can be in body part. Introduction should be direct, we should be very direct. Okay. What is the keyword here? American War of Independence. Write an introduction with that. Very good. You are actually giving the entire answer here, sir. Don't give that also. What will you write in body? Restrict that. It's good, but don't write everything. And then what you will write? You will only duplicate your points. Okay, then. Then. Then, yeah, I need some more intros. Good, good, simple enough. Simple enough is good, fine. Yeah, then, ladies, late history. I want answer from your side now. Girls, tell. Yeah, fine. Here again we can show you some information that we know about this thing. 1770s he told, we include date, 1770 is the exact date, 1770s you can write that. Okay, history means some dates, right? So write some date, may not be exact date, 1770s. Okay, we all know there were 13 colonies fought against the hegemony of British imperialism. Simple intro. Okay, that is your introduction. Then come to the body. Yes. Tell me, what is the structure first. What is the structure first? Then we'll go to content. Structure. Cause of revolution. Yes. Just that will be only in 3 to 4 lines. Maybe 3 to 4 points. Okay. If it's a 15 mark question, again segregate according to the marks. Okay. If a 10 mark question, need not mention that. Just 2 lines. You can just tell many causes, or you can draw a circle. You can just put some causes there. Navigation Act, economic policy, political policy, stepmother treatment, all these things, religious policy. Okay. If it's a 15 mark question, write in points 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay. See according to marks. Then one is cause for revolution. Yes. Then what next structure in body? Yes. What about? No, need not. That's not the demand of the question. Was American Revolution, was it American Revolution or true revolution? That is a question. Now you need a broad thinking. Yeah, exactly. That is the thing. Yes. So how will you write that? I didn't get you. Yes. That is the answer. That is the exact answer. But how will you write it? How will you segregate it? Discuss. Directive discuss. Okay. Discuss means basically it's a dialogue. We are discussing, right? Now we are discussing. Your answer should be in that format. Okay. Was American War of Independence a true revolution? Discuss. You gave introduction. You told the causes of the war. Now we come to the main answer. Okay. You can say yes, it was a true revolution. Write your points over there. Next, it was not a true revolution. Write your points under that. Then conclude. That is the structure. That's what I'm asking you. Yes. First thing, try to conclude your answer positively. Whatever is the subject, try to conclude positively or criticize constructively. Don't criticize everything. Don't at all. Don't never ever. Just don't put criticism, but put constructive criticism. Okay. So first, we'll come to the negative part. It was not a true revolution. It was not a true revolution. Why? It was good. Good. Yes. Good. Good point. Then general point. It's a very general point. This is a good relevant point. Yes. Then. At least 4 to 5 criticism. Good. Slaves, not slavery. Slavery. That's why we had in 1800 the Civil War. Very good. That should be the first point actually. The second point, women's rights. Then, very good. Very good. It was not universal franchise. Okay, the slogan they gave. Of the people, by the people, for the people, but it was only for the 10% of the people. So not for everyone. Property, you need to have property to practice your voting rights. Very good point. Then, most of the people who were in this Philadelphia conference, they were money lenders. Okay, they were fighting for their own economic rights, private rights. Okay, it was not a revolution. It was a more, what you call it, a sectorial interest. Even you can come to that thing. Second thing, when they were waging war, okay, there were some people within the colonies, they don't want to wage war. Like in India, you can compare in world history, try to compare with modern India. Okay, at least one point if you remember. Like when we had our independence movement, when we had this moderate phrase, what moderate thought? British Raj is good for India. There also they had the same thing. Same thing. When they were some George Washington and his army was fighting, some were supporting Britishers. It's good for US. Okay. So that can be a criticism. 3 to 4 points, more than enough. Whatever it all is very much relevant, is 100% relevant. Good. Come to the other part. Yes, it was a true revolution. Tell me how. That is come priority wise. First thing is, first time a colony was defeated, British was defeated. Okay, yes. Then whatever you told, yes, that's second point. Written constitution, first country to practice federal democracy, federal, true federal democracy. Okay, written constitution, bills of right, like you told. Then it had an impact on French Revolution. Because see the timeline again. Timeline. After American Revolution, we had French Revolution. Right? Timeline. then led to decolonization. Yeah, and there you need to put an example of South Africa, South America. South America, it was decolonized in within 1830s itself because of US. And then come up with general points. Come up with very general points. What we see America of today, the superpower, its roots were in 1773 Civil War, yes. The feeling of nationalism, we are Americans, yes, we the people. It impacted Europe, it impacted India, yes. Then capitalism, theory of like communism is from Russia, capitalism is from US, yes. They followed this laissez-faire policy. Then take your syllabus, economic, polity, social, okay, come like that. You can get one point in each set of subheadings. Yes, elected. Within the federal, you can write elected form of, you have the presidential form of government. Yes, you can write that. Practical implementation of the democratic principle, Montesquieu's principle of separation of power, legislative, executive, and judiciary. Practical implementation. Okay, so these are the impact. What can be the conclusion? Yes, you can write that. This one will go to conclusion then. I would have written like maybe the process of independence was not revolutionary, but the aftermath were. The aftermath were truly revolutionary, which is even impacting or have an impact in contemporary world, okay, making America the strongest nation among all. Okay. We can also talk about America's dominance in World War One, World War Two. It's only because the roots were sown in 1773. Think beyond. Okay, so 1773 is not only that war. Go beyond. Whatever happened after that, we need to discuss. That is revolution. Okay. Scope of a map here. Yes, we can draw a map here. Okay. We can draw America. From America, we had ideas of liberty, equality, fraternity. You can bring that. Federal democracy. Okay. Capitalism. All the points we have written, you can put in map and where it had an impact. Right hand impact. Sometimes decolonization, you can say, how Indian independence movement, you can say about World War II, World War I, okay, formation of UN, League of Nations, all these things from America. Okay, you can draw a map and even consolidate all your points in that map. You can do that, even that. Okay, so that is about this question. Getting it? How to write? How to approach? Getting it? Little idea? Okay, so this is the basic thing, basic exercise. I wanted to show you how you can, without even knowing, you didn't study, you did not prepare, right? Were you prepared for this class? Did you read world history? No. But still you are able to write. Okay. So reading alone will not help, thinking will help you. That's what I wanted to show you. Okay. So coming forward, I think IGP program, you have a test on Saturday for world history. Yes. So next 5 days, what are you going to do? What are you going to do? So before playing the real match, do net practice. Okay, which is we have started today. Next 5 days till Saturday, do this writing practice. Just one question. If you're not writing, feeling it very bored, please structuring. At least do structuring of previous 5 years questions. Previous 5 years question. Okay, dedicate 2 hours to study. Because without studying, coming for test is of no use, waste of time for you, right? 2 hours, 3 hours, make a timetable for you, according to timetable, study that. Okay, syllabus wise, only 2 syllabus, and take last, if you are structuring answer, structure 5 questions every day. From previous year, if you are writing, write 2 questions every day, okay? But within time, because none of you are freshers, okay? Write time bound answers. If 10 mark question, take 8, 9 minutes. usually you should take 7 minutes, take 9 minutes, 15 mark, take 13 to 14 minutes instead of 11 minutes. But try to stick to that time and write your answers. Okay, and when you are writing, the only thing you need to focus is structuring. Okay, content is okay, you will do it, not an issue. You generate within that pressure, you will even write what you are not studied. Okay, your mind is actually the most, what the God's most wonderful creation is your brain. Okay, it can do anything only if you believe. Okay, so content, just whatever you are studying, study that. Okay, focus on structuring. Now we just saw, right, when you structure your, write the side ending structure thing, you get points automatically. You can generate points automatically, right? So first thing, those who have like out of touch with the subject, start with Arjun Day for next 5 days. Okay, previous is UPSC questions. Okay, and every day writing practice and structuring. That will be the basic main agenda, and we'll see how it works out on Saturday when you write the complete test. Okay, and after test we'll discuss how everyone has written. Okay, how you have structured, what benefit you have taken from this class. Okay, so we'll discuss that, and what innovation we can, further innovation if required, we can bring in our answers to get that extra half mark, 1 mark in each question. Okay, so getting it, we'll do it. Okay, then all the best. We'll see you on Saturday after test.